morning on Saturday the 29th of October, and the St. Luke's team send our love and blessings to everyone. Our opening prayer. Loving Lord, we seek your ongoing help during these difficult times, and we pray that we all continue to apply common sense and look out for the needs of others at present. Amen. Today's readings are Psalm 121 and Philippians 4, verses 4 to 9. Virtually every day in the news, we hear an interview where sadly someone is saying in a despairing voice, "I don't know where to turn." I think that the interviewers must have a really difficult job knowing how to respond. If they say something like, "I understand what you're saying," it feels rather cold. People don't want a response to the effect that they can't see a way out of it either. But also, if the interviewer passes some sort of reassuring comment, such as, "Don't worry," I think that sounds a bit patronising. Yet, it's so easy to say and think, "Don't worry." But the simple fact is, humans do worry. And this is exactly what Paul says to the Philippians. "Don't be anxious, the Lord is near." What St. Paul is writing about is the active nature of prayer, and through it, giving God the chance to show how he can, in fact, work. The opening of Psalm 121 gives the answer. Our help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Perhaps an essential part of asking God for help is to be prepared to be part of the answer to our own prayer. It's part of that listening to God, responding to our prayer, rather than as just giving him a list of demands to sort out. We have opportunities to put into practice each and every day what we learn from God. God does indeed know all about us, that's a fact. And he knows our potential and how willing we are or otherwise to serve him. And of course, God knows exactly what it's like not to know where the next meal is coming from or where he's going to sleep, because that was all part of the itinerant nature of Jesus' ministry when he was here on earth. There are things which are so big that literally we don't know where to start our prayer. We just feel that situations are overwhelming. Yet, when faced with this, I think that perhaps we can make a start by praying about something linked to it, which we are able to grasp and get our heads around. And then, as we do that, God graciously builds up our faith as he responds and he enlarges our outlook and encourages us to be bolder in our prayers. The next prayer: Almighty God, who in your great mercy gladden the disciples with the sight of the risen Lord, give us such knowledge of his presence with us that we may be strengthened and sustained by his risen life and serve you continually. Amen. Our prayer points. his focus around those big issues which can seem overwhelming to us, but about which God wants to hear from us. So let's pray about climate change. Pray about the war in Ukraine, and pray about the cost of living. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Don't forget that later on this evening, the clocks change, and we move them back for an hour. Tomorrow, there are services at St. Aidan's at 9:30 and 11 o'clock. And I'm assuming that St. Luke's have now managed once again to be able to access St. Wilfrid's Academy and will be worshipping there at 11 o'clock. And just to mention an event taking place on Monday, that's the 31st of October. I've previously commented that as Christians, we don't encourage Halloween or the celebration of the dark side of life. But we don't want people to miss out on a party. And so at Blackburn Baptist Church, there is a free party entitled A Bright Party. A party which focuses on light and good. That's taking place between 6 and 7:30 on Monday the 31st. Everyone is welcome, and it really doesn't matter what age you are. If you want to party, go along and join the fun. And our blessing. The Lord give you grace and make you to be numbered with his saints